Good morning.
Good morning.
I'm sorry we're slightly late. How it goes in Salvation Army, in Elsmere Court. But you are very welcome to this place, and welcome so many visitors today who have never been into this place before. And you are very welcome here on this special day as we welcome a new soldier into the Salvation Army at Elsmere Court. We're so excited. We don't know what's going to happen. We do know he's going to be enrolled.
Yeah.
So if it's your first time here, and maybe you know nothing about the Salvation Army, although I really hope Lawrence has explained it to you, but maybe you don't really know what's going on today. I hope by the end of this service, you will have a better understanding of what's going on. The Salvation Army is a church. We meet every Sunday to worship God, a Christian church, and also a charity. The Salvation Army all over the world does all sorts of things. And so you'll hear more about that as we go through our service. And so you'll see Lawrence is here today in uniform. We've cut the cotton off. So. There's no bits hanging off, and he looks very, very smart. He did all the sewing himself, which is amazing, isn't it? So, if anyone needs any work doing, So, we're going to begin our service this morning with a prayer, and then we're going to sing together. So, let's pray. Father God, we come before you this day and we say thank you for this new day. And Lord, we thank you that we can come into this place and freely worship you. But also we come to celebrate with Lawrence as he stands and gives his life as a soldier in the Salvation Army. Lord, we thank you so much that he can come and do that here today. And so, Lord, we want to pray that your Holy Spirit would move amongst us today.
Amen.
That you would speak to each one of us, no matter who we are or where we come from. And I pray that you would have something powerful to say to us today. So, Lord, we wait upon you this morning. We pray your blessing upon everything that takes place this day. And we say thank you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Well, in the Salvation Army, we love music, okay? We love to sing. We have a drummer here. Bill plays the bass drum. And so we're going to begin our service by singing together a great Salvation Army song, Send the Fire, which was written by the general of the Salvation Army, the founder of the Salvation Army, William Booth. When we speak of fire in the Salvation Army, don't panic. Because we're talking about the fire of the Holy Spirit who comes and empowers us and strengthens us for all that we have to do and all we're called to do by God. You'll see on the screen there, blood and fire, which we see on our flag. Again, don't be scared. The blood of Jesus is what we're talking about. Jesus, who gave his life freely for us. And so there's loads I could tell you about the Salvation Army. I'm not going to lecture you today, but we're going to sing together, Send the Fire. Would you stand together and we'll sing.
Thank you.
song. That's a prayer of the Salvation Army, that God would send the fire of his Holy Spirit to give us the strength to go out into this world and to serve him. We want the world to be different to how it is now. We want the world to be turned upside down because of Jesus. So look out, because it's all happening today. So we thank God and we praise him. I've asked Bill. Bill is one of our oldest soldiers, just one of them. And I've asked Bill today if he would come and read for us. And he's going to read for us, "I'll Fight." And this is said to be the last speech that General William Booth, who founded the Salvation Army, said to be the last speech of William Booth. They're great words, and I felt it would be good to begin with these words, so thank you, Bill.
"I'll fight while women weep as they do now. I'll fight while little children go hungry as they do now. I'll fight while men go to prison and in, out, as they do now. I'll fight while there is a drunkard left, while there is a poor lost girl upon the streets, while there remains one dark soul without the light of God. I'll fight. I'll fight to the very end. Fire the volley." But he always used to say,
"Thank you, Bill."
And I didn't hear one volley.
Thank you, Bill. "I'll fight to the very end." The Salvation Army, an army of people who have said yes to serving Jesus, and it's all about him. Thank you, Bill. In this world of darkness, we need the light of Christ. We're going to sing together a hymn you may know, "Be Thou My Vision." And we ask today that God would come and shine his light into our hearts so that we might see and see how things can be different. Let's sing together, "Be Thou My Vision." Just remain in your seats as we sing. we pray that this morning. Now, I don't know how many of you have come into the Salvation Army and you don't know much about the Salvation Army. You maybe see on your television screens adverts from us telling you something about what the Salvation Army does. Maybe you didn't even realise we're a church as well as a charity. Well, now you do. And so I thought it might be helpful this morning just to show you a clip which explains something more about what the Salvation Army does. The Salvation Army works throughout the world in 128 countries around the world. I'm trying to work my way around them. And so many different things go on, we can't even keep up with it, can we? The Salvation Army does so much. So I'd like just to watch this clip to share more with you about the Salvation Army. Salvation Army and the mission of the Salvation Army throughout the world. Not so long ago, Lillian and I were in Iceland and we trekked for 3 days to raise money for the Salvation Army, and we found the Salvation Army, didn't we? We knocked on the door and no one answered. Which is very disappointing. But in most places you go throughout the world, you can find a Salvation Army. Knock on the door and say you want a cup of tea. I'm sure they'd be, apart from in Iceland, they'd be willing and happy to do that for you. The Salvation Army is for anybody. All people are welcome into the Salvation Army. Nobody is excluded. This leads me on to the way that we met Lawrence. It feels like Lawrence has been here for many years. But actually, it wasn't too long ago that Lawrence came into this building because of an activity that was going on through the week. And the Alzheimer's Society were running a group here for people with dementia called Team for the Brain. And Lawrence came and helped with that group. It's great because we have Jill here, who led that group, and she's come to celebrate with Lawrence today. And Lawrence, I'm surprising you now because Jill kindly came to one of our other groups and she did some handbell ringing with our cameo group, which went down a storm. And so I said to her today, because she kindly gifted us some handbells, and I said to her today, do you think we could do a chorus with the handbells? And she said yes, which is brilliant. And Lawrence has chosen the song today, Trust and Obey. And so what we're going to try to do is the chorus of Trust and Obey on the handbells. Now, you're not escaping this because I need helpers. So Jill, would you like to come and lead us? Jill is a teacher, so she's much better than me at doing these things.
I was a teacher. Did it ever go?
No.
Lawrence, this is the new set. This is for you. So you're going, Lawrence, the keeper of the bells.
Thank you.
This is the old set that we've experienced. And I'm actually, Louise, I was going to do the whole thing. A whole verse.
Oh, that's great.
Would you like a verse? Of course, I can do the chorus for you. Okay. But I would like six volunteers, please. Six volunteers. All you have to do is ring your handbell. When I point to you. Well, actually, I should have said, I really could do with people stood here, stood across here, because I need to point to you.
So,
Deb? Otherwise, it'd be difficult because I've been pointing all over the room.
Go on, Lawrence.
Lawrence, you have to be seen. You have to be seen. You're the main man. You come this side. So C. Do you like to be next?
Yes.
You're D.
I'm a D.
You're a D. Come over here.
Over that side. No, come over this side. Come over this side. Once we get it right over, keep going, you've got to go over that way.
I'm
the furthest right.
Are you?
Yes.
Apparently. We start with C.
Keep going.
This way.
When I point to you,
play.
Okay, just when I point like that. Yeah. So we'll just have a quick practice looking down.
No, there you go.
This is a variation of Trust and Obey. It may not be perfect. So we'll do the verse and the chorus. I hope you recognise it. You know the tune. I hope you recognise it. Let's see. Here we go. Wait. Watch me. And when I look at you, I'm playing your bell. Here we go. Let's start again.
Yeah.
do the chorus again. Well done, but it's a bit difficult to sync to that. But
volunteers. We're going to sing that song now. When we walk with the Lord in the light of his word, what a glory he sheds on our way. While we do his good will, he abides with us still and with all who will trust and obey. Trust and obey. You won't forget that today, will you? So shall we stand together and we'll sing.
Suit while I was sat down. Don't pay this much for a suit like this and then mess it up.
So we stand with the flag of the Salvation Army, and this is Susan Duncan. She's our treasurer here at Ellesmere Court. And we welcome you, Lawrence, as we share together just now. And first of all, I want to read you some verses from Scripture. Okay, listen carefully. I'm reading from Ephesians chapter 6, verses 10 to 18. Finally, be strong in the Lord and in his mighty power. Put on the full armour of God so that you can take your stand against the devil's schemes. For our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the powers of this dark world, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. Therefore, put on the full armour of God, so that when the day of evil comes, you may be able to stand your ground. And after you have done everything, to stand. Stand firm then, with the belt of truth buckled around your waist, with the breastplate of righteousness in place, and with your feet fitted with the readiness that comes from the gospel of peace. In addition to all this, take up the shield of faith with which you can extinguish all the flaming arrows of the evil one. Take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. And pray in the Spirit on all occasions with all kinds of prayers and requests. With this in mind, be alert and always keep on praying for all the Lord's people. Amen. Amen. Well, Lawrence stands here today, and to become a soldier in the Salvation Army, you complete a time of preparation. And Lawrence has completed that along with a group of us. We had a brilliant group, didn't we? Sharing together. We have explored together the doctrines of the Salvation Army, the beliefs of the Salvation Army, why we do what we do. And we've explored together the soldiers' covenant, the promises that Lawrence is making today to God. Lawrence has been challenging. Lawrence has been brilliant because he's asked lots and lots of questions. He has challenged us all, and that's been great because we need to explore and question our faith. We need to know why we believe what we believe. And so, Lawrence, I've been grateful for that challenge. That's been really good. Today, Lawrence will make a promise to God, and he will sign his soldiers' covenant. And so today, Lawrence felt he wanted to read to you the doctrine and the covenant that he's making today. You can follow this through on the screen, okay? And Lawrence is going to read to you. This is his declaration of what he's doing today.
The Soldier's Covenant. Having accepted Jesus Christ as my Saviour and Lord, and desiring to fill my membership of his church on earth as a soldier of the Salvation Army, I now, by God's grace, enter into a sacred covenant. I believe and will live by the truth of the Word of God, expressed in the Salvation Army's 11 Articles of Faith. We believe that the scriptures of the Old and New Testaments were given by inspiration of God, and that they only constitute the divine rule of Christian faith and practice. We believe that there is only one God, who is infinitely perfect, the creator, preserver, and governor of all things, and who is the only proper object of religious worship. We believe that there are three persons in the Godhead, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, undivided in essence and co-equal in power and glory. We believe that in the person of Jesus Christ, the divine and human natures are united, so that he is truly and properly God and truly and properly man. We believe that our first parents were created in a state of innocency, but by their disobedience they lost their purity and happiness, and that in consequence of their fall, all men have become sinners, totally depraved, and as such are justly exposed to the wrath of God. We believe that the Lord Jesus Christ has, by his suffering and death, made an atonement for the whole world, so that whosoever will may be saved. We believe that repentance towards God, faith in our Lord Jesus Christ, and regeneration by the Holy Spirit are necessary to salvation. We believe that we are justified by faith, by grace through faith in our Lord Jesus Christ, and that he that believeth hath the witness in himself. We believe that continuance in the state of salvation depends upon continued obedient faith in Christ. We believe that it's the privilege of all believers to be wholly sanctified, and that their whole spirit and soul and body may be preserved blameless unto the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. We believe in the immortality of the soul, in the resurrection of the body, in the general judgment at the end of the world, in the eternal happiness of the righteous, and in the endless punishment of the wicked. Therefore, I will be responsive to the Holy Spirit's work and obedient to his leading in my life, growing in grace through worship, prayer, service, and the reading of the Bible. I will make the values of the kingdom of God and not the values of the world the standard for my life. I will uphold Christian integrity in every area of my life, allowing nothing in thought, word, or deed that is unworthy, unclean, untrue, profane, dishonest, or immoral. I will maintain Christian ideals in all my relationships with others, my family and neighbours, my colleagues and fellow salvationists, those to whom and for whom I'm responsible, and the wider community. I will uphold the sanctity of marriage and family life. I will be a faithful steward of my time and gifts, my money and possessions, my body, my mind and my spirit, knowing that I am accountable to God. I will abstain from alcoholic drink, tobacco, the non-medical use of addictive drugs, gambling, pornography, the occult, and all else that can enslave the body or spirit. I will be faithful to the purposes for which God raised up the Salvation Army, sharing the good news of Jesus Christ, endeavouring to win others to him, and in his name, caring for the needy and the disadvantaged. I will be actively involved, as I am able, in the life, work, worship and witness of the Corps, giving as large a proportion of my income as possible to support its ministries and the worldwide work of the Army. I will be true to the principles and practices of the Salvation Army, loyal to its leaders, and I will show the spirit of Salvationism, whether in times of popularity or of persecution. I now call upon all present to witness that I enter into this covenant of my own free will, convinced that the love of Christ, who died and now lives to save me, requires from me this devotion of my life to his service for the salvation of the whole world, and therefore do here declare my full determination, by God's help, to be a true soldier of the Salvation Army.
Thank you, Lawrence. So you may think, that's a lot, isn't it? But I want to tell you that it's all about Lawrence's relationship with Jesus. And his relationship with Jesus enables him and helps him to do this. And so I'll put that back. What I'm going to ask you to do is, if you would stand with me, stand with us. You here are witnesses, and we thank you for coming and supporting Lawrence. And we ask that you would continue to pray for him in these days. But just now, Lawrence, do you declare in the presence of God and this congregation that you undertake, by the help of the Holy Spirit, to live and work as a true soldier of Jesus Christ and of the Salvation Army, according to the witness and promises you make this day? If so, raise your right hand and say, I do.
I do.
Thank you. We're now going to ask Lawrence to sign his covenant, and he's going to do that today at the mercy seat. in the Salvation Army. And so he will be kneeling as he comes before God and makes that covenant. So please take your seats and just pray for Lawrence as he does that. So Lawrence, I charge you today to keep your promises and by the grace of God to be a blessing wherever you go. I encourage you to regularly remind yourself of the covenant that you have made today. And may God bless you richly as you serve him as a soldier in the Salvation Army. In the name of the Lord whom we love and serve, I accept your declarations and receive you as a soldier of the Ellesmereport Corps of the Salvation Army. Please, would you welcome
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. This is brilliant. Susan is going to pray just now, and then Lawrence is going to share with us his testimony.
Shall we pray? Oh, Father God, we just want to say thank you this morning. We want to thank you for Lawrence, for his life, for his work, for his witness, and for the fact that he's responded to your call to serve him, to serve you here in Ellesmere Court. Oh, Father, we just know that you will bless him. We know that you have a plan for him here. And we know that through the power of your Holy Spirit, that he will be empowered to fulfill the calling that you've made to him. And Father God, that we as a corps here will support him. And we pledge this morning to support Lawrence in prayer and practically as he journeys along this path that you've chosen for him. Our Father, we just thank you for everything you do in this church and in this community. And we just want to pray this morning that we as a church will be loyal to your calling as well. So again, Lord, we thank you for Lawrence. We thank you for this wonderful occasion. We thank you for reminding us all of the promises that maybe some of us have made to you. But more than that, Lord, reminding us of the promises that you make to us. Those promises, Lord, are never broken. And we thank you again for that. And Lord, we just pray that everybody in this hall this morning will leave this place knowing something of you that's special and personal to each person. So Father God, we just pray all this in and through your precious name. Amen.
Amen.
I just want to say thank you to everybody for coming. It's been just so nice, and so many good friends and all sorts. So thank you for taking the trouble to come. And we are actually streaming, so you never know, the people in Florida, we've got good friends in Florida, in the Baptist Church in Florida, hopefully it's a bit early in the morning for them yet, actually, because it's 5 hours.
Scott's on.
Oh, they're on.
Yeah, Scott is.
Hello, Scott. Hello, Angela. It's Angela's birthday as well today. Happy birthday, Angela. I have lots of things. I particularly need to thank Louise because she's right. We had lots and lots of discussions and went on for hours. And they were challenging times, and there was one particular issue that we really stuck with. And if you wanted me to explain that to you, I will do. It's all got resolved in the end. At 2:30 a.m. Unbelievably. I nearly rang Louise to tell her that it was all sorted. But I want to thank Louise for her infinite patience, because she did. She spent hours trying to explain, but she never told me what to believe. She helped me think it through and work it out, which was great. And above all, thank you to God for an amazing journey that started 40 years ago. Because, as you may have already gathered, this service isn't about me becoming a Christian. I became a Christian 40 years ago, as I'll explain in a minute. This is about dedicating myself to a new path with the Salvation Army. I'm just so proud to become a part of it. So, I'll take you back to the 1st of May 1977. That's when I became a Christian. But I'll take you back before then. I don't know whether you can tell from my accent, because I've got a little cockeyed accent, but I was born in Chester, so not very far away. The family all went to a little Baptist church in Chester. And I heard the gospel lots and lots and lots and lots of times. A good faithful church, just as this one is. I tried to be a good human being. I don't know if it was that bad, not quite human standards, are they? But I was not a Christian. That's the critical thing. Being good doesn't make you a Christian. I think the first person in our family to become a Christian was Linda, my eldest sister here, who I believe gave your life to God in Billy Graham Crusade, was it? Yeah, Billy Graham Crusade. But I mentioned Linda in particular because, and she probably doesn't even know this, but she was a huge influence on me. I remember sitting in a church service once, and I was sat next to Linda, and we prayed the Lord's Prayer. And I listened to Linda, and the thing that struck me is she's talking to a person. She isn't just reciting the words, she's talking to a person. And that stuck with me years and years and years later. So when I was 11, we moved to Surrey. We went to church again. Mum and Dad both became Christians. I still wasn't a Christian. We moved back to Chester. We went back to Hull Baptist Church. And I was, I don't know whether I'm going to go back there or not. And then they got a new minister, and they needed help for his inauguration, or whatever it's called, moving the chairs. So meeting a helpful person, went along to help move the chairs. Met the pastor and his wife, thought, something different about these two. Started going, and he preached a series of sermons, and each week he was talking to me. I don't care what anybody else in the service was doing, that message was directly to me, and it was all about the broken reed and the smoking flax. He's talking about the very slightest hint of faith that God will blow in and gently bring into a flame. And that's exactly what happened to me. For me, my challenge in the Baptist church was communion, the Lord's Supper, because I knew from a very early age that this was a very special thing, but it wasn't something you took unless you're a Christian. You had to have made your own personal decision to take that. And I knew I wasn't. And week after week, when we used to have it, I would literally start sweating. I'd see the plate coming, but I knew I wasn't a Christian, so I just let it pass by. And nobody said anything, nobody got upset, nobody looked and shouted at me or preferred me. And then on the 1st of May, it was coming around again, and I started to sweat, and I thought, you know, I want to give my life to God. This is it. And I made a decision there and then. No great emotions, just said, I want to give my life to God. And I have never been the same since. Within weeks, I'd met Brenda. Now, for those of you that don't know, Brenda was my lovely wife. So we met very shortly after I became a Christian. She was already a Christian, had been a Christian for a long time. I think it was something like 27 weeks, we were married. We very quickly decided we were going to get married, because it was just obvious. Brenda was sadly a widow, and she was married to David, and Ruth is David's sister. Is here today. So I've got brother and sister-in-law. And the song we sang when we walked with the Lord, that was Brenda's song. Every time something happened in Brenda's life, when she married David, Damon's funeral, when we got married, at Brenda's funeral, because as you may know, Brenda, sadly in 2000, got Alzheimer's. And she lasted very well. God was really good to us. She lasted 15 years, and we sang that at her funeral as well. As the Salvation Army would say, promoted to glory, which is a much better way of looking at it. But Brenda never got angry, she never complained, she never got angry with God, but God never left us. I know we're in some really tough times. I know there's people here going through really tough times. God never left us. At the time when Brenda passed away, we were going to Neston Christian Fellowship, and we've got good friends from Neston Christian Fellowship. I'll spot you wherever you are. Good friends from Neston Christian Fellowship. But after Brenda died, it was too heartbreaking to carry on. I sat at some of the Brethren of Red, just in tears, because Brenda would have been there with me. So I started looking around and had pretty well decided which church I was going to. I didn't feel particularly led to go there. Lovely, lovely church. Lovely, lovely people. But for lots of practical reasons, seemed the right way to go. And then the Alzheimer's Society, who was now the volunteer, said, "We're starting a new thing, starting Singing for the Brain in Ellesmere Court. And it's going to be led by a lovely lady called Lynn, Jill, would you come along?" I said, "No, fine." So I walked through the door sometime in May. I'm not quite sure where, what time in May, but met people from Salvation Army. Decided to come the next Sunday. And I think it was the third week. I was sat somewhere around there, and I'm not even sure the service had started. And I just felt, this is home. It literally felt like that. And then the new start journey started, and I started reading about it. I didn't do anything without checking it out. And so I read all about the Salvation Army, read all the information I could find, and then started asking questions of the leaders. Eventually I felt that the Lord was saying, "I want you to A, become a part of this church." And you can become an adherent, which means you just sort of join the church, but you can. I felt the Lord saying he wanted to be a soldier. And when I met Louise, I don't know if she remembers this, I said, "Yeah, I'll join the church. I'm not going to become a soldier, and I am certainly not going to wear the uniform." Certainly. God really doesn't have a sense of humor. He really does. So what changed? Well, I truly and honestly believe this is where God wants me to be. I've seen how people, and I didn't know much, if you came here this morning, not know much about Salvation Army, ditto. I knew nothing about them. I'd never even walked through the door of Salvation Army until I came through. But I've seen how it's possible to interact with people because you're the Salvation Army. They may or may not realise you're a church, but you soon get the chance to tell them that, and you soon get the time to give them the gospel. But it opens so many doors to people. Just the fire arm playing the ropes to them. Songs of Praise a few weeks ago, there was a piece about Salvation Army, and I spoke to a lady there, and they were asking her why she joined the Salvation Army. And she said, "It's Christianity with its sleeves rolled up." And I think that says it exactly right. And unbelievably, I truly believe that God wants me to be an officer. So we're looking forward to that as well. That's like a few years. The last 15 months have been a whirlwind. But God has been so good to me. And I have never moved so much furniture in my life. Honestly, it's just unbelievable. You should start up a different business. I've signed literally on the dotted line. And I've no idea really, apart from wanting to be an officer and how that will go. I have no idea what the future holds. It's going to be an exciting time, that's for certain. But I know for a fact that God is going to be with me 100% of the way. And I cannot go without, sit down without saying that he wants to do that for every single person here. You may or may not already know the Lord. You may have known the Lord in the past and sort of wandered away. Well, now's the time to come back to him or come to him for the first time. You will not regret it. Thank you.
Thank you, Lawrence. It's a great testimony that Lawrence has to share with us about all that God can do and how God surprises us. Lawrence said, no, I'm not doing that, I'm not doing this, and he's done it. God can do anything. And so believe that today if you don't believe it already. We're going to sing together, I Stand Amazed in the Presence. And hopefully today we can stand amazed in the presence. Lawrence was just going to say about this song.
I've got to say this because this was another early, early morning epiphany. This is probably 1:30, 2:30 in the morning. And I woke up and I thought, we've got to have this song. And I know I need to write it down. If I don't write things down at that time in the morning, it's gone by the following week. So I wrote it down. Next one, as soon as I woke up, I was onto YouTube looking for versions. Found one, rubbish. Found another one, other good. Found this one, thought, perfect. And then started watching it, and I realised that I was there with Brenda at the recording of this song. It was the Songs of Praise 50th anniversary. And Irene, I see Irene, she's here somewhere. Irene was there too. So God does it all. It's just unbelievable, but it's a great song.
So you have a sheet for the words for these because you may not be able to read the words on the screen. So we're going to stand together. We need to stand for this one. Okay, let's stand together. I stand amazed in the presence.
Thank you.
just now we're going to take up an offering. This is part of our worship. If you would like to give anything to the work of this church, please do so in these moments. Celebrate.
Our Father, we've been singing about how marvellous and how wonderful you are. And we want this morning that our giving just reflects how we feel about you. We thank you for everything you do for us. We thank you for everything you are to us. And we just pray, Lord, that as we bring our gifts into your house, that they will be used wisely to extend your work in Elsmere Court. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you for your gifts today. We're going to read from Scripture again. We're reading from 1 Timothy chapter 6, verses 11 to 16. 1 Timothy chapter 6, verses 11 to 16. But you, man of God, flee from all this and pursue righteousness, godliness, faith, love, endurance, and gentleness. Fight the good fight of the faith. Take hold of the eternal life to which you were called when you made your good confession in the presence of many witnesses. In the sight of God, who gives life to everything, and of Christ Jesus, who, while testifying before Pontius Pilate, made the good confession, I charge you to keep this command without spot or blame until the appearing of our Lord Jesus Christ, which God will bring about in his own time. God, the blessed and only ruler, the King of kings and Lord of lords, who alone is immortal and who lives in unapproachable light, who no one has seen or can see. To him be honour and might forever. Amen. Amen. I just have a few words for you today. Just a few words. We go on to the next screen. Do you recognise this? Big Ben. Big Ben in London. Has anyone been there for real? Yeah? You've seen Big Ben. Have you heard the news about Big Ben?
Yeah.
He's gone quiet. Big Ben has gone quiet. The bones are no more of Big Ben. For, is it still 4 years?
Yeah.
4 years. Big Ben will be silent. And you may agree with that. You may not. You may not care. I don't know what you think today. We've had bells here today in our service. We heard that beautiful song, Trust and Obey, with the bells. I was thinking about the bells. I was thinking about Big Ben, because it's such a huge noise, isn't it, that's made when Big Ben chimes. And I was thinking, those bells draw attention, don't they, to Big Ben. People are caused to look up to Big Ben. And I wonder now, when he's silent, are people just getting on and not really realising that Big Ben is there? I don't know. Those chimes draw attention. This got me thinking. As a soldier in the Salvation Army, we're called to live out the soldier's covenant, which we heard Lawrence read to us. And the final part of the covenant says that the soldier witnesses that they freely enter into this covenant, convinced that the love of Christ requires the devotion of their whole lives to his service for the salvation of the whole world. Your whole life for the salvation of the whole world because of the love of Christ, because of all he has done for us, because he said yes to us, we say yes to him and offer everything back to him. And that love is for everybody today, the whole world, not just a special few, the whole world. And so, Lawrence, today I'm not comparing you to Big Ben. But as a soldier in the Salvation Army, it's important that we fight the good fight of faith. At times we need to be loud like Big Ben, because at times we are called upon to speak up when nobody else wants to speak. When nobody else wants to get involved, we are the ones sometimes who God says, you stand and you speak. Sometimes we need to speak up where there's injustice, where people are treated unfairly, where people are suffering. We need to speak up. We need to be determined people who believe in a God who has done the impossible and goes on doing the impossible. And we need to, by our actions and words, cause people to look up to Jesus, not to us, but to Jesus. Just as when Big Ben chimes, people might look up and they see that great big illuminated clock face. They see the light. We are called to help people look up to Jesus and to see his light. In Luke 11, verse 33, Jesus said, "No one lights a lamp and then hides it. Instead, a lamp is placed on a stand where its light can be seen by all who enter the house." If a light is on a stand, people can see the source. And so we are called to take that light into a world of darkness. I imagine too, Big Ben kind of wakes people up if they're walking past and they're close to it and suddenly the chimes go off. I'm sure it wakes people up and it alerts them to what the time is. If they didn't know it already, they're thinking, oh right, that's the time, 6 o'clock or whatever. We are called as soldiers of the Salvation Army to help wake people up, to help people to know that the time is now. That these things of the world are not going to go on forever, but there is a God who is eternal, and he gives each one of us a choice today. Timothy said, "Fight the good fight of faith. Take hold of the eternal life to which you were called. Lawrence, pursue righteousness, godliness, faith, love, endurance, and gentleness. Point people to the Saviour. Now you have devoted your life to his service for the salvation of the whole world." And maybe you're here today and you've no idea what I'm talking about. Maybe you're here today and as we talk about fighting the good fight of faith, you're thinking, no thanks, I've got enough battles of my own going on. I don't want to get involved in another one. I want to tell you today that there's a God who can help you out of those situations. There's a God who fights for us. There's a God who walks with us through all that we face on this earth. And so maybe today you find yourself thinking, who is this God? Do you want to know him? You can today. God is here with us. Maybe you've been a soldier in the Salvation Army for many years. Maybe you'd forgotten all this stuff you promised many years ago. What's God saying to you today? I'm going to pray and then we're just going to listen to a song. And I want to just pray that God would speak to us in these moments. We're going to listen to the soldier's hymn as we think about the battles that we are in. but the God who is a good God, who fights for us. So let's pray. Father God, we thank you for these moments. And Lord, we may be thinking about all sorts of stuff right now, thinking about where we're going after here, or how we're getting home. Lots of things might be going through our minds. But Lord, in these moments, I pray that you would just draw very close to us and that you would be able to speak to us today. Lord, you know every person here. You know their needs, you know their situations. And I just thank you that you love each one of us and that you offer us today a saviour. So Lord, in these moments, would you speak? So we just watch and listen to this song as we just spend some moments. Sorry about that wrong song. This is the soldier's hymn. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the love that you offer to each one of us. We pray now as we move from this hall, we pray that your Spirit would go on speaking to us and challenging us, Lord. And may we be willing to follow you. Lord, I ask this all in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Well, our closing song today is Rejoice, Rejoice, Christ is in you. And we thank God for this day. Thank God for Lawrence. Well done, you did it. Thank you, everybody, for coming and sharing this day. After the service, there is food through in our community hall, or if you just want a cup of tea, come and share with us. You are very welcome. We'll need to just pace ourselves as we go through. Okay, but bear with us. So we're going to stand together and we're going to sing. Rejoice, rejoice. Make a noise. If you don't know this song, just make a noise as we rejoice with Lawrence today. Let's sing together. Sure.